Tap to the mighty scholars of Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School, and welcome to a new week of cyber programming with Sankofa. It is Monday, April 20th, and things look a little different today. Yes, I understand that. But we're going to do something a little different today. Today, we are going to take a look at the pouring of libations that we missed on Thursday. We are also going to take a look at the recognitions that we had as well. And we are going to see the word of the day, and you are going to also see our read-aloud story that we missed on Thursday. We're not going backwards. We're just making sure that we are staying consistent. I wanted to finish off with our book, Little Legends, Exceptional Men in Black History. And I wanted to make sure that I finished out with the last story that I wanted to share with you with that book, because that leads right into our book this week. Our book of the month is still Little Legends, Exceptional Men in Black History, but that is connected to Little Leaders, Bold Women in Black History. This week, we are going to be sharing stories of three of our bold women in Black history. And I wanted to make sure that we finished out properly. So this week, today, we are going to see the video that I had ready for Thursday. We had some technical difficulties with copyright issues, things that I'm still learning on my own. Just like you guys are learning new things with this technology that we're doing, I'm learning as well. And I'm just making things right. And so I hope you guys bear with me. So please make sure that you check that out. And again, when we go into the video, make sure that you are standing in a strong angaleya. We are following libations. You are going to get the word of the day from our story, our read aloud story. And before we get into that, I want to recognize two scholars, Rodney Tanksley and Riley Lynn Benjamin. They both sent me videos. I'm going to get the chance to share those videos. I just have to work a few things out. I was unable to share one video because of the copyright issues, but I am going to make sure that you guys get your videos posted, because we are sharing videos, and I want to encourage scholars to continue sharing their videos so that we can see one another. Also, I'm really happy about Friday's Harambe. We had our Students of the Month along with some facilitators, and we did Harambe together. Brother Issa was there, Sister Joy was there, all of our facilitators were there, and we did Harambe all together, and it was a wonderful experience that I am going to continue to have. Continue to participate, continue to be interactive with me, and I will send you an invitation to join me on Zoom so that we could do Harambe together again. So, you know, you never know who you're going to see on Zoom. Maybe we'll see everybody. You never know. But anyway, let's go right into Morning Circle with Baba Mark. It is Monday, April 20th. Oh, and by the way, when you sign in, first comment down below the word of the day, but also when you go onto the website sfacs.us, click on Cyber Program, go all the way down before you get into your work. Go down, click on Attendance Tracker. You will click on that and put your name in and the word of the day, and that will be your attendance. Then you will get to work with your class's work. And speaking of classwork, parents, I do have an announcement. So parents, please make sure that we are checking our emails every single day. Please check your scholars, your child's email every day, at least one time a day, because facilitators are sending scholars emails with instructions on the work and other details. So please make sure that you are checking your students' emails, because we like to maintain communication with one another. So without any further ado, family, let's start off with Morning Circle. You're going to notice a few things that maybe have to do with last week, but this is Morning Circle. Pay attention and stand in Angalaya and listen for that word of the day, and check out one of our guest drummers today. And I will see you soon. Have a wonderful day. Peace. I love you. Bye-bye. let's get ready for the pouring of libations. And today I'm going to be watering two of these plants because yesterday I neglected this little one. And I want to make sure that it gets water. And we are pouring life into the plant. And when we are outside, we pour into the ground. Indoors, we pour into something that is providing soil and providing life. And so that is what libations is about. Giving life and love. So please all stand in a strong angalea. And of course, we have permission to begin. And to that, we say, Ashe, Ashe. We pour libations to the gift of life and learning, Ashe. We pour libations to the energy that woke us up this morning, Ashe. To the energy, to the creator that we know of many names, we say, Ashe. We pour libations to the cradle of civilization, Ashe, known as Africa. We pour libations to the many nations, the kingdoms of Africa, kingdoms that we are named after, kingdoms like Kemet, Kush, Yoruba, Songhai, Congo, Zulu, and Maasai, Ashe. We pour libations to the kings and queens of these nations, kings like Mansa Musa, King Shaka, Queen Amina, Queen Nzinga, Ashe. We pour libations to the freedom fighters of these nations, Ashe. We pour libations to the many people who left the continents of Africa and gave birth to humanity across the world, Ashe. We pour libations to those who remained on the continent of Africa and helped the continent flourish and thrive for thousands of years, Ashe. And we pour to those whose land was taken from them and who were taken from their land unwillingly. To those lives, we say, Ashe. We pour to those who endured the Ma'afa, the Black Holocaust, the many lives that were lost across the transatlantic slave trade, the Middle Passage, the Ma'afa, Ashe. And we pour to those who survived across the Middle Passage and made it across to the New World, North America, Central America, and South America. To those lives, we say Ashe. And to those nations, those kingdoms that were here, Ashe. The Mayas, the Incas, the Iroquois, the Taínos, the Caribs, Ashe. We pour libations to the freedom fighters of these new nations, Ashe. Freedom fighters like Toussaint L'Ouverture, Nat Turner, Medgar Evers, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Harriet Tubman, Rosa Parks, Ashe, Ida B. Wells, Ashe, Ella Baker, Ashe, Fannie Lou Hamer, Ashe, Huey P. Newton, Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the institutions that teach us about these, about our history, about our legacy. Institutions like the HBCUs, Ashe, and Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School, and Imhotep, and the Freedom School Movement, Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the educators, those who continue to teach us, the facilitators, those who educate us and learn about our history and teach us about our history so that we can move forward, Ashe. And the scholars, those who are going to continue to learn and those who are going to continue to build upon this foundation, Ashe. And we're going to pour also affirmation to the babies and the babies' babies and those who are going to come and complete our circle, Ashe. And lastly, family, we pour to the ancestors, and we hope that they accept and they receive and accept this libation. Ashe, Ashe, Ashe. Yes, family, welcome to another Morning Circle with Baba Mark. I hope that you guys are well. Thank you for standing. You may have a seat. Family, the principle of the month is, and that means... Yes, the principle of the month is Nia, and that means purpose. And I am so happy that so many of you are leaving comments about purpose. I mean, it is amazing. And that's showing exactly what our purpose is. Our purpose is to educate ourselves and to grow and to love. And so I appreciate that. And so let's remember to always celebrate and appreciate our Nia, our purpose. Yay, Bo. Yay, Bo.
Little Legends, Exceptional Men in Black History by Vashti Harrison. Today's legend is Benjamin Banneker, inventor and farmer from 1731 to 1806. Although Benjamin attended school for only a few years before working on his father's farm, he loved to read and study. He became so good at math that people came from all around Maryland to test him with questions. They were amazed at how quickly he answered them. He would ask questions too, writing them as poems. Benjamin wanted to use his abilities to help people. At 15, he created an irrigation system that kept water flowing to his farm's crops. It was so effective that even during droughts, the Beneker farm flourished. In 1753, he became fascinated with his friend's watch. Watches were rare at the time, and his friend let him borrow it. Benjamin studied the watch and eventually built his own full-size clock, the first built in America. News of Benjamin's clock spread throughout Maryland, and he was approached by George Ellicott, a landowner and amateur astronomer. The two became friends, and George lent Benjamin some of his astronomy equipment and books. Benjamin became obsessed with the stars, lying down all night to observe the skies, then going to sleep after dawn. When people saw him in bed during the day, they thought he was lazy. As his knowledge grew, Benjamin even spotted errors in George's books. Around 1791, Benjamin wrote an ephemeris, a chart of the movements of stars and planets. George's cousin Andrew read it and asked Benjamin to be his assistant for a very special project, surveying and designing land that would become Washington, D.C., the young nation's new capital. Benjamin agreed, and they set to work. When his project with Andrew was over, Benjamin returned home and worked on an almanac, a book about upcoming natural events. He used this writing to speak about the injustice of slavery and defend the humanity and intelligence of black people. Benjamin Banneker was an exceptional scientist and inventor who, through quiet observation and diligent work, helped shape American history.
Story for today about Benjamin Banneker, and I know a lot of us have learned about Benjamin Banneker at Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School. I mean, he was the creator of the first clock that was created in America. Before that, there were clocks being built in other countries, and we were bringing them over here. He created the first clock, and when everybody heard about it, they just went to him, and he was doing all of these things at such a young age. And he was responsible for building the Washington, D.C. that we see today because of his knowledge of the stars and land. And so it was so important for us to learn about Benjamin Banneker. And so, family, our word of the day, and although you may not have heard it in the story, I want to make the word of the day time. Again, the word of the day is time, T-I-M-E. And the reason I chose time was because Benjamin Banneker was a master of his time, and he knew about time. And when we're talking about time, we're just not talking about time on the clocks, but also time in space. The way that we manage time is so related to the stars and our sun and the way our land moves, and he was such a master of that. And so when I think of time, I think of how we use our time properly. Like right now, what are you doing during this time? And are you wasting time, or are you using it right? I personally am a firm believer of time being more valuable than money. Money, you can earn it back, but time, you can't get it back. Once it's gone, and you got to keep it moving. So what are you doing with your time? And what does time mean to you? And also, if you want to answer this question, what does time relate to our story about Benjamin Banneker? So again, the word of the day, family, is time. Again, the word of the day is time. And so make sure that you comment down below and give me your comments so that I can recognize you. And I'm hoping that somebody could send me a video, maybe talking about what time means to them. And you know, we'll post it on there. But right now, it is time for our recognitions. I said I have a recognition. I said I have a recognition. So family, my recognitions today are brought to you in part by time, because this is all the time we got right now. So anyway, family, I'm being silly. I have a recognition, and my first recognition actually comes from, my first recognition is to Mama Dana. I want to recognize Mama Dana because she's been making comments down below and just and really being part of Morning Circle, and I so appreciate you, Mama. Mama Dana says that her favorite Langston Hughes poem was The Negro Speaks of Rivers, and I appreciate that. Langston Hughes was one of my favorite poets and my favorite poems, Cross. But Mama Dana's favorite poem from Langston Hughes was his very first poem, published poem, and that's The Negro Speaks Rivers. Also, Mama T would like to recognize a couple of scholars. Mama T, shout out to Mama T. She would like to recognize Jose, Zuri, and Nakai. They were the only scholars to get their open response question about symmetry correct. So good job to Jose, Zuri, and Nakai. And that is from Mama T. Thank you, Mama T. I appreciate you. Our next recognition goes out to Anaya Howard, once again, who says that rhythm makes her think of music, beats, relaxing, sounds, and more. Those are some very powerful words right there, especially relaxing. I need to relax, and rhythm does help me relax. So I appreciate that, Anaya Howard. Isaiah Thomas says that rhythm makes him happy and that he thinks of song and movement. Thank you, Brother Isaiah. I appreciate that. Zuri Artist Powell says that she uses rhythm to make TikToks, which is great. A lot of us are doing that. Maybe you want to share a TikTok with us, Zuri. And Nakai Artist Powell says he uses rhythm when he beatboxes. Maybe you want to share that with us as well. Soleil Hardy Mover says that rhythm is movement and purpose that you sometimes need to just hear. And you just need to hear that one beat to get to that happy feeling. So thank you for that. Again, Soleil says rhythm is movement and purpose that you sometimes need to hear that one beat to get that happy feeling. So thank you for that. Randy Jameson says that he thinks of beats and rhymes when he thinks of rhythms. All right, so many of you made so many comments. Please, when you are making comments, read other people's comments and comment on other people's comments. Have that conversation with one another. Let them know you see what you're saying. I see what you're saying. Let's have a conversation about that. Let's do that. Also, folks who have been commenting, I want to recognize Dennis Holmes. Thank you, brother. Munir Riggins, once again, he's always involved. Ajanae Brodus, always see you on there. Soraya Burnett, who thought of Benjamin Banneker. Yesterday, she thought of Benjamin Banneker. I don't know if she knew that I was going to read it today, so shout out to Soraya Burnett for that. Dior Austin, who was commenting as well. Ramaya Jameson says that she thinks of jazz when she thinks of rhythm. I love jazz, so thank you for that, Ramaya. My Asia Gonzalez Williams says that if it wasn't for rhythm, music would not have the same joy and happiness that it brings to people. You're absolutely be right about that. We need rhythm. Tamaya, she says that her purpose is to being successful and to help others. Thank you so much, Tamaya, for that. Ahmad Turner, shout out to you, brother. Shout out to Hope Whitehead. And family, I forgot to make a special recognition, a special birthday recognition to Mama Tawana. Her birthday was on Monday. And so I want to ask Stevie just to come on just for a second and sing happy birthday to Mama Tawana. You ready for this? All right, sing it, Stevie.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to Mama Tawana. And family, I'll be honest with you, I don't see any birthdays this weekend, April 4th, anybody in the lower school. And if I'm missing your birthday, please shout me out on the comments down below and let me know. Bobby Martinez or Bobby Mark, you forgot my birthday. And I'll make sure that I shoot you a recognition, a happy birthday recognition. And so family, tomorrow is Friday, and I have a very special treat for everybody, and I hope that everybody could sign on. I'm actually going to be calling a few of you to make sure that you're down with it. But anyway, I shouldn't have even shared that. But anyway, I'm going to close out with a final statement and our moment of silence. When we think about our NIA, our purpose, we have to think about time as well. And it's funny how all of these things tie in to rhythm and purpose. And so many of you talked about self-determination. They all tie in together. And at this time, there are so many things that we could be doing. We could be worrying. We could be wasting our time on electronics or just being bored. And we have to make sure that we find the Nia for this time. This time we are not in our school buildings and we are being asked to do things that we may have never done before. And so we have to find our rhythm in that. And it may be difficult to find that rhythm because we've never heard of this rhythm. And so you have to think about what folks like Langston Hughes did. We never heard poetry like Langston Hughes's poetry. And creators like Duke Ellington or Louis Armstrong or Chuck Berry, these were creators of music, of rhythms that were never heard before. But now here we are and we hear them often. So because this is a time that we have never experienced before, what are you creating? This is your time to be creative and do something that has never been done before that maybe could be useful in the future. So let's think about that. It's deep, right? Because I've been thinking as well, like, what am I doing? What are my daughters doing that can be different, that can make this time productive, this time useful, and this time to have Nia, purpose? So let's think about that, family. Let's think about all of that. And I know it's a lot, but try to hold on to it and think about it at this time in our moment of silence. And the moment of silence begins now. And family, I want us to take a deep breath. I hope that you guys have a great day of learning. Make sure you sign into sfacs.us. Click on that link, Cyber Programming, Nova School. Go to your facilitator's work and make sure you get that work done. And make sure that you are spending your time productively. Yay, Bo. Yay, Bo. I will see you guys tomorrow for a very special Harambe. I love you all. Peace. Bye-bye.